Zooming, I picked up a fuse. Oh no, the switch. Alright, so I need to find. Looks like I need to find some fuses. Because I'm presuming that's how you open up Pack-a-Punch. Oh, I need the... I think I just picked up a fuse, so it doesn't actually display it. Very surprised there's no meal kick. Unless if there is meal kick, I've not seen it yet. Like some custom firing mode thing. Don't push it. I'm very surprised there's no mule kick. I'm very surprised. Stamina up, to be fair, stamina up on this type of map, we don't really, it's not really necessary. pen out. Shut up, bitch. I don't know why, I'm just in the mood to shoot a shotgun. I'm just in the mood to use it. Cool looking camo. I generally thought I threw the monkey outside somewhere, but no, it worked perfect, right? Zombies didn't even go for it. Just be dropping a lot of drops. This burger's alive. Thank you. You just have to ruin it and make it free burst. Why? We can't do a pack. Oh, so whoever the map maker is, they've proper made it so it's like Black Ops 2. Is that the reason why the Ray Gun Mark II didn't push it? It didn't use... Well, the Ray Gun Mark... Wait, what? Is that the reason why I don't push it? Because it didn't do it on Black Ops 2, did it? Whoa! What the hell was that? Whoa. Have I secretly got on Deadshot or something? What's this? Footfire. how far I can't climb up ladder anymore. Whatever you do, don't make him a Kimbo burst. Thank you. double click. Hey, what's up, Ethan Hunt? How's it going? Hey, what's up, Ethan? How's it going, dude? Okay, the pack. What? Wait. Apparently, I just. How the hell did that just work out like that? Yeah, I'm doing all good. Doing all good. Just chilling. Really? Just chilling. Playing some zombies. I'm about to blow myself up. I'll deal with you in a minute, pen. I'll just, let me just quickly get all the zombies down for a minute. Good old Pernell. Damn power hungry. Well, plus, to be fair, without Pernell, well, they could have obviously got the elemental shard, because since they had summoning key and whatnot, they could do anything they want, but... Yes, it is. Well, it's just DINER. It is, it's just DINER. It's just the DINER bit. The map's just called DINER. I know this map's been like been remade so many times, because I think the latest one that they've kind of done is Daybreak. It's got its like own like Easter egg. It's like got mixtures of Alpha and Omega in it as well. And but I know there's a dude who's creating a map that is basically doing all of Transit. I think he's doing all of Transit. And he's also, I think he's also doing like parts of like how Black Ops 2 was. You can play Transit, then farm, tan. And obviously Diner. I think that's what he's doing. I could be wrong though. Because I know someone's also doing Die Rise, I think. I think someone's created Dime Rise. Because I'm pretty sure this map's been out for a very, very long time. I think this map's been out for a long time. Yeah, it's been out since November 2020. So it's nearly 4 years. What's my favorite weapon in Zombies history? It's two weapons. But it's like I've always summoned an odd about them. Because I just like them as equally as they are. And that's the Blundergat or the Thunder Gun. So I say my to be fair, I reckon I say my most favorite weapon in Zombies has to be the Thunder Gun. Only just because when you shoot zombies with it, it sends them flying. That's the only reason why. And pretty much nearly any single map that has it, you can pretty much just survive forever. And then I say my most favorite wonder weapon has to be the Blundergat. It's easily the Blundergat. My most favourite wonder weapon is easily the Blundergat. What happened to the classic pack-a-punch music in Cold War? It's because the classic pack-a-punch, well, the pack-a-punch in Cold War is not classed as the pack-a-punch anymore. Which I'm very surprised they didn't, because the only reason is when they made Cold War, it's within the new timeline. It's the... It was the timeline that Richtop and, well, that Nikolai created. Hence what Richtofen wanted to do, but then because of the Dark Aether, and obviously in World War II, again, it was messing about with stuff, and then obviously they found, basically they just opened up the Dark Aether, but the Pack-a-Punch, they didn't call the Pack-a-Punch the Pack-a-Punch anymore, they called it the Forge. But then they just totally just scrapped that because then on Modern Warfare 3 Zombies, they call it the Pack-a-Punch. But it's still got the Forge on the machine, well, on the Pack-a-Punch. That's the reason why. That's why there's no jingle. Plus, at the top of the machine, plus, as you can see on the Forge, the top of the machine is literally destroyed. It's only got the middle bit. But I just don't understand why they changed it to the name of the Forge, and then they just went back to Pack-a-Punch. Because obviously the dude who created it, he doesn't exist anymore within the new timeline. Plus the keepers don't exist anymore. Like, that's what we think anyway, but yeah. I do know it was supposed to be longer. I think the main reason why they changed, the main reason why they took it out is because of the fact there isn't really a place on a map where, I don't even think there really is. There's not really a place on any map that you literally near the Pack-a-Punch all the time. So it's like, even though the song started playing, you wouldn't be able to hear it anyway because you'd not be able to have time because you're picking up the weapon and then obviously zombies have been near you. Because the song, that plays, it's literally just it's just telling you the story of Jemadiah Brown. I think that's his name. He was the one who created the Pack-a-Punch, the guy from Buried, and then is the keeper. A keeper told him to create it. Actually, to be fair, there was actually a custom map that I recently played. Well, say recent, I think I played it like a week ago, I think. Every time the person made it, so every time you actually pack a punch, it played the song. Because they even had the... They even had the full quote of when you get, when you pick up Fire Sale. Because there was actually a full quote. Whenever you picked up Fire Sale. It didn't just, used to just like... When the when Black Ops 2 first came out, whenever you got a fire sale, Samantha actually started saying, like, kind of ironic that I get a fire sale. Because she starts going, good evening, I think she says, like, good evening, zombie shoppers. The box rolls for $10 or something. And then she laughs. But then, literally within the first patch that they did for Black Ops 1, they took it out. Because then from that point on, you never heard that quote ever again. They never put it in any other zombies or anything. They just full on just took it out of Black Ops 1. But if you play, but if you do get Black Ops 1, say if you buy Black Ops 1 for the 360 or PlayStation 3, but you don't make it, make sure that you're not connected to the internet when you put it in, so you don't get the patches. If you start playing Kino, you will get that quote. Because even I can remember getting it. I can remember getting it when back on Black Ops 1. I can remember getting it. I think the main, or the whole reason why they got rid of it is because of the way it sounds. It sounds very demonic, since it's obviously Samantha. Since at that time, that's when kids started playing it and stuff. Well, even saying that, to be fair, even I was still a kid when I was playing Black Ops 1. What's my favourite perk of all time? Deadshot. Deadshot's my all time favourite perk. Especially when Cold War came out. When they actually changed. Since they literally changed Deadshot into the, like, the most OP perk that they could have ever, like, brought to zombies. Well, I should say they buffed it so much that it turned it into, like, a god tier perk. But then they kind of, when Cold War came, they made Deadshot. But then within, I think, when the first DLC dropped, I think, or it could have been the second, they nerfed it. But in a way, it still worked how it works, and it's still to this day, when you get Deadshot, it still works because it still works the same as on Modern Warfare 3 zombies, but without the perk upgrades for Black Ops. I mean, I keep saying Black Ops 3, for Modern Warfare 3 zombies. Because since when they put the perk upgrade, well, I shouldn't say when they put, because obviously on Cold War it was in since day one. One of the upgrades for Deadshot, or I think it was the last one, it basically made it so every time you hit a weak point, so headshot, or when you're shooting at the manglers, you shoot the arm, his head, and then mimics, it was the head, his face, his mouth, and then disciples, it was his hand and his head. You basically did double damage. So pretty much just think, your guns literally did double damage, and it basically changed it into the gobble gum that when you were shooting at a zombie, no matter what part you hit, it classed it as a headshot. You were shooting them in the head, and basically that's what they kind of turned Deadshot into. They made it so every time you shot a zombie in the head, you did double damage. But then they changed it, they nerfed it, so it was technically the first bullet that you hit. Because I think they changed it so if the zombie was hurt, you didn't get the effect. That's what they changed it to. So if you literally did like one HP of damage, you didn't get the double damage, but you still got the benefits of Deadshot. Yeah, I did play World at War, but obviously I've not played World at War in years. I haven't played World at War in years. But still to this day, World at War has still got the best Pack-a-Punch camo to date. Obviously the good old chrome Pack-a-Punch skin from Iris Still, without a doubt, the best perk, best camo, pack-a-punch camo to date. And then they brought it back on... They kind of brought it back on Black Ops 2. Wait, Black Ops 2 or Black Ops 1? I think it was Black Ops 2. But it didn't look as good, though. Personal records 1-3-5. My personal record on World of War is 350. And this was genuinely the first week when Shunonuma dropped. It was literally within the first week of Shunonuma. When Shunonuma dropped, that's when I got to 350. That would have been, mate, to be fair, you talking to me right now, you would have been talking to like a famous, 1,000,000,000%, you would have been talking to like a famous YouTuber, zombie YouTuber, 100%. If I actually uploaded that video to YouTube, because that was back when people used to use Dazzles to record. But when I was playing, when I was actually playing the map, back on World at War, when you're connected to the internet and you basically play, when you're playing zombies and you're connected to the internet, but then you lose connection to the internet, it doesn't upload it to the leaderboards. It doesn't upload, or I think it uploaded the point that you got to when you go in, because I think it saved it for when you went on to a next round. I think that's how it worked. But if you get disconnected from the internet, it doesn't upload it to the leaderboards. And I can remember, well, I'll always remember this, because if I did actually upload it, I would have 100% been a famous YouTuber. Zombies YouTuber, 1,000,000,000%. When I was playing, my brother came in and he turned the internet off because he wanted to restart the modem. He did it on Natchty Town. Sweet. Even Natchty Town, the first ever zombies map, but it's actually the most easiest zombies map. Only because Natch, World at War, or if you played on Black Ops 1 with the whole remastered maps, you could get the flamethrower. Which we all know, the flamethrower is the best weapon in all of zombies, because you can literally just fart on them and then you just wait for them to die and then you just rinse and repeat. You could just rinse and repeat. And then Verruckt came out. Changed it up a bit with the whole super sprinters. Traps. Perks. Well, no, because the only thing, like, with the thing with zombies, like, with, especially, well, it's like, it's literally, like, from the beginning. It's not really hard to play zombies, like, genuinely, you just, to play zombies, you just got to have patience. That's all you've got to have. You've got to have time and patience to do it. Especially if you, obviously, if you played like Natch and, I mean, World at War, Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2. Because you literally had to. You literally had to rely on like the strat to do and the whole setup type thing. Because ever since they obviously brought the whole, well, from Black Ops, on this Black Ops 3, the whole having Blast Furnace, Dead Wire, Turned, and all that. You could literally just get any type of weapon and then you could just shoot it and it turned it into a wonder weapon. Especially Dead Wire. Since Dead Wire is like the best one to use because it literally activates every 3 seconds. So it's like you've literally just turned it into the Wonder Waffle. You've full on just turned, you literally turned any weapon into the Wonder Waffle. Because it's even the same with, it kind of was the same with Thunderwall as well. Because Thunderwall just basically just turned it into the Thunder Gun, but it was just literally just a little blast. But it didn't, like, trigger as often, but Deadwide, it just constantly nearly triggered. Random, I'm trying to get 40. For years, the one RAM that I always get to is 40. But I get there without going down. I do it flawlessly. I never buy Crit Revive. Like, I genuinely, like, back when I used to play this, all the old zombies. Because nowadays, Crit Revive, you need Crit Revive because it gives you the whole, your whole health regeneration. But I never buy Crit Revive, I never. But yeah, the rounds that I always get to is 40. Pretty much nearly every map that I play, I get to 40. Get to 40 flawlessly. Without going down. And if I get, if I'm playing a map and I get downed, I just immediately just, well, obviously if I go down, I'm dead. Because I don't buy Crit Revive. But obviously there's some maps when you beat Easter eggs, well, some custom maps, I should say, you beat the Easter egg and then you get quick revive because it gives you all the perks. So it's like as soon as I go down, I just quit anyway. There we go, Rav. 40. And I have kind of made it harder for myself. I could even, I wish I could even make it even harder for myself, but you can't put two mods on at the same time.